Hello and welcome. I'm Amritanshu Rai and you're watching Law of the Land on Raj Sabha TV. Today we bring to you the High Court and Supreme Court judges, salaries and conditions of service amendment bill 2017. To discuss the issue, I have with me Dr. Justice Satish Chandra, former judge, Allahabad High Court, and Dr. Justice G.C. Bharuka, former acting chief justice, Karnataka High Court. Now for the highlights. Bill seeks to hike salaries and allowances of judges. Bill seeks to cap the highest pension. Additional outgo is expected to be 20 crore rupees. The High Court and Supreme Court Judges Salaries and Condition of Service Amendment Bill 2017 seeks to revise the salaries, allowances and pension of judges. Once the bill is passed, the salaries of Supreme Court and High Court judges will more than double. The additional outgo from the exchequer is expected to be around 20 crore rupees.
The salaries, allowances and pensions of the judges of the Supreme Court and High Courts were last revised 11 years ago. The Seventh Pay Commission recommendations for central government employees have already been implemented. This resulted in an anomaly where salaries of top government officials are around 2.5 times higher than the salaries of judges. The bill, when enacted, will involve an additional expenditure of 12 crore rupees annually towards salaries and 8 crore rupees towards areas of salaries, pensions and family pension.
I think that this is perfectly justified and was much needed, long overdue. It was pursuant to the letter written by the Chief Justice of India in 2016. It's taken the Parliament 2 years to react.
The High Court and Supreme Court judges Salaries and Conditions of Service Amendment Bill 2017 seeks a revision of salaries and pension benefits with effect from the 1st January 2016. The salary of the Chief Justice of India will go up from the existing 1 lakh rupees per month to 2.8 lakh rupees per month. The salaries of other judges of the Supreme Court and the Chief Justices of High Courts will go up from 90,000 rupees per month to 2.5 lakh rupees per month. The High Court judges who get 80,000 rupees per month at present will get 2.25 lakh rupees per month.
The purpose of the bill is to enhance the salary primarily of the High Court and Supreme Court judges. Now, it is a periodical exercise. After every 10 years, there is an enhancement of the salary and other connected perks and all those things of all the central government employees and the members of the All India Services. Now, in consonance with that, it is necessary by practice and convention that the salaries and the service conditions of the judges should be proportionally increased.
The President, having been informed about the existing disparities in salaries, recommended the bill for introduction in the Lok Sabha. The bill was tabled by Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad on the 11th December 2017 in the Lok Sabha.
Once the hike is effected, the salary of the judges will be at par with those of bureaucrats following the implementation of recommendations of the Seventh Pay Commission. Nishtha Malhotra with cameraman Sudhanshu Bhushan for Rajya Sabha Television.
Enhancement of judges' salary is a routine affair and closely linked to the Pay Commission recommendations. Is it enough, even after enhancing it to the present level of 2.25, 2.5 and so on per month, is it good enough to attract the best talent available into judiciary?
this is a highly debatable point, whether salary will be sufficient for the judge or not. Everybody will say it is not, certainly, and they would like to enhance it. But question remains that the position of the judge in the society is different. That is very honorable word. Judge is very honorable word in the society. People are coming after earning so much money just to get the honor, just to get the reputation. And justice word is itself is sufficient. So that is one aspect. Money earning, they were charging as an advocate in the courtroom for the bail, even 1 crore sometime, 51 lakh rupees, 11 lakh rupees. So they have not come for money. They have come for the reputation. They have come for the honor. And they have come here to serve the nation.
Right, sir.
That is the one thing.
So keeping that in mind, sir, what is your take? Is it good enough to attract the talent that the judiciary requires at the highest level?
Now, in my opinion, one should bear in mind two things. Number one, when a person becomes a judge or agrees to become a judge of the superior court, particularly the high court, then he comes there or gives his consent to become a judge primarily for the purpose of serving the society and not for earning livelihood. Therefore, in my opinion, if the salary offered and the perks given to the judges are sufficient enough to lead a decent life, I think that should be enough. And the present enhancement, that is consolidated. There is a misconception that the salary is being doubled. It's not. The judges were getting the salary with basic at 80,000, and with that was added the dearness allowance. The net figure that they were getting was almost 2 lakhs. And there is an enhancement of only 25,000 rupees. To the existing pay scale along with the DA. This was explained by our law minister, Mr. Ravi Shankar Prasad, in the parliament when the bill was tabled. Therefore, as I have said, it is only a consequential enhancement to maintain a parity between the salaries given to the civil servants and the judges who have a special constitutional post.
So, sir, effectively, getting you in, if the enhancement is merely notional as of now, as it appears, is that good enough to for the judges to allow them to live a life that a decent life, as sir said?
My brother, senior brother, rightly said this is just a meager enhancement because DA was crossing 100% and that was merged. So hardly they will get 23,000 rupees benefit in the basic pay. That's the aspects. Whether this is sufficient after the enhancement or not, this is again question
for a decent life.
Decent life, because as long as he is a judge, he is getting more perks. He is getting so many facilities. For example, he is getting the government accommodation. He is getting the 3 sevaks, servants at his place, and all vehicles, etc., fuel, free electricity, and even water. All are free. So he is leading a good life.
Okay.
But after problem comes after the retirement.
That's when the dip happens.
Yeah. Then all perks will go except the medical facilities and pension. So then he is not leading a good life. I have seen so many judges, they are standing in the queue of the railway reservation sometime. No facilities available to them, no assistance is available to them.
Which is not a dignified thing.
Not a dignified. A retired judge is standing in the queue.
Right. Do you have a point to make there? I mean, obviously, post-retirement, the status sees a major fall. And since the justice word sticks with them for all their lives, even if he has demitted office, is it...
That has nothing to do with the salary or the quantum of pension that they are getting. A judge retires at the age of 62. By that time, his family responsibilities are always over. And the problem with the judge at the age of 62 are the same as they are with the ordinary senior citizens. Therefore, as a senior citizen, whatever the common man gets, a judge gets much more than. I know it.
Right.
That even progressively, even the retired judges are given protocol services by all the high courts.
Right.
But sir, just protocol services by the high courts, but that is very poor. That will be provided after the services provided to the sitting judges. In Allahabad High Court, there are 160 judges and functioning 100 judges. So, first of all, they will provide the services, protocol will provide the service to the 100 judges. Then retired judge will number come.
So, there has to be...
And that is negligible. And ultimately, they will say, we don't have car, we don't have any facility to carry you to the hospital.
So that,
and no facility is available to carry to the hospital at the old stage, age.
So, the infrastructure at the High Court level and the Supreme Court level also needs to be expanded so that these tertiary services can also be offered to someone who has held the office of a judge.
My suggestion in this regard is this. In foreign countries, they are getting the salary throughout the life.
Correct.
Last, and they never retire unless they are physically unfit, but salary will remain there. But in India, what we can do at least, because this pension is coming from the Consolidated Fund of India. But purse are coming, facilities are coming from the state.
Right.
Consolidated funds.
Right.
That is the difference. Why you are not bringing to the Union of India and make a uniform? For example, Chhattisgarh High Court is providing the stenographers, driver to the retired judges. And other high courts, Odisha, UP, they are not providing.
So, it varies
and
from state to state.
Sikkim High Court is providing the medical allowances in advance. They always give you the impress money, 20,000 every time in your pocket.
Right.
You submit the bill, then next money will come.
Correct.
But other states are not. They are asking the bills and sometimes they are taking so much time. And bills are still not passed. And so, that is the last priority in the High Court. So, why you are not making a section, particular section, in the under the Justice Branch to have a Consolidated Fund of India? And all these retired purse along with the pension uniform.
Right.
And so quick processes will be there.
Right.
If unless you will not make attractive these services, especially after the post retirement, then they, I doubt whether this
will be able to attract the best talent.
To attract the talent or not.
Okay. It's time for us to head into a break. When we return, we will tell you more about the pension and allowances provisions proposed in the bill. Welcome back. The High Court and Supreme Court Judges Salaries and Condition of Service Amendment Bill 2017 also seeks to raise the allowances and pensions. The bill will benefit over 2,500 retired judges.
Under the existing law, judges of the High Courts and the Supreme Court will be entitled to an official residence without payment of rent. If judges do not use this entitlement, they will be paid a monthly allowance equal to 30% of the salary. The bill seeks to revise this allowance to 24% of the salary.
According to me, the salary even now, which is suggested, it is far less than what they deserve. If you are wanting a good practicing lawyer to become a judge, then you have to offer a very, very handsome salary for a lawyer to take, and that is why good lawyers are not interested in becoming judges. I personally feel that judges should be given a much higher salary than even what is proposed now to attract the best of talent, and they should also be given full salary till they remain alive, that means even after retirement, so, and they should be debarred from working. That will ensure that they work fearlessly, that will ensure that they will never be dependent on anybody else for their monetary needs. And that will bring in that kind of institutional strength which the judiciary at the moment is lacking.
According to the bill, a sumptuary allowance is paid to judges of the High Courts and the Supreme Court for entertaining visitors. The bill seeks to revise this allowance with effect from 22nd September 2017. It is proposed that the Chief Justice of India, who presently gets an allowance of 20,000 rupees every month, will get 45,000 rupees. Other judges of the Supreme Court and Chief Justices of the High Courts, who now get 15,000 rupees, will get 34,000 rupees. The other judges of the High Court, who now get 12,000 rupees, will get 27,000 rupees. The bill proposes to cap the highest pension that can be drawn by the judges. The Chief Justice of India presently gets an annual pension of 6 lakh rupees, which can go up to 16.8 lakh rupees per annum. The other judges of the Supreme Court and the Chief Justices of the High Courts presently get 5.4 lakh rupees as pension, which will be hiked to 15 lakh rupees per annum. Other judges of the High Court who presently get 4.8 lakh rupees may get 13.5 lakh rupees per annum.
The government is in charge of the finances of the country. All the, this salary comes from the Consolidated Fund of India, and therefore it's the government alone which regulates that consolidated fund, and there has to be a law with regard to raise the salaries in, by the parliament, so that the government can spend more money out of the consolidated fund.
The pension of the judges of the High Courts and the Supreme Court was last enhanced in 2006. The 7 Central Pay Commission recommendations have been already implemented for central government employees in 2016. The revision of salaries, allowances and pensions of judges is being recommended to bring parity in remunerations. Nishtha Malhotra, Rajya Sabha Television.
The pay commissions are the starting point for the revision of salaries of the judges, and the pay commissions essentially are for the civil servants. The way it happens, sir, my question to you is, the way it happens, do you think ever it's going to be possible that the judiciary could also be considered at the same time rather than follow the pay commissions? So is there a possibility of the judiciary ever being able to be part of the pay commission in any way?
I think this is the most desirable thing to be done, and it is a matter of policy, and the executive should initiate this process in the larger interest of the society and the governance.
Mm-hmm.
The executive should not always keep the judiciary dependent on their discretions. For them, the bureaucracy and the central government seems to be more important than the judiciary itself.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is a step brotherly treatment. Why it is being done, it is still to be discussed and found out.
What is the constitutional framework guiding the principle of payment of salaries to the judiciary? See, as of now, they are, the judiciary is entirely dependent on the executive for all payments. So what is the constitutional framework according to which this entire mechanism is organized, and what are the finer points that need to be retained for this mechanism to continue?
In the constitution, they have given a separate chapter for the judiciary, and just to maintain the independence of the judiciary. So protection is given in the constitution. Even their salary cannot be revised without amending the constitutions, without making, that is why it took 2 years. Government servant got the salary long back on the 7th pay commission, and the judges will get after 2 years, because constitution is required to be touched. That is amended, that is there. And funds are always controlled by the parliament for the judges. So independence is there, and funds are coming from the consolidated fund of India or consolidated fund of the state, as the case may be. So that is there. So constitution has already given the protection for this one. Executive cannot touch that fund or that salary what has been prescribed in the constitution.
Having said that, is it possible for the entire exercise to be implementable at the same time rather than with a lag of 2 years?
Rightly you said earlier, is there a possibility to create an independent body for recommendation and study this salary of the judges? That is for the government, that is for the Chief Justice to recommend such type of committee who will examine every aspect and will recommend, make a recommendation. Because pay commission is nothing, they are just making a recommendation. Even 7th pay commission, I was the head of the 3rd pay commission of the PSUs, so I have made a recommendation. And then it is for the government to accept it. And had not government introduced this bill, judges might have not got the payment. So it is always the executive to introduce the bill in the parliament.
Right. Is there a way out to somehow minimize this 2-year lag because it normally follows the seventh pay commission. And as sir rightly pointed out, that it cannot happen. The 2 years is the delay because the constitutional obligations have to be fulfilled by the government and the constitution has to be touched. And in order to do that, the lag happens. Is there a way that this lag could be?
The constitution does not debar the government from authorizing the same pay commission to look into and advise for incrementation of the salaries of the judges of the High Court. There is no barring to it. Why it is being made dependent on the salaries of the bureaucrats of the executive, this is difficult to understand.
Mm-hmm.
This exercise can be done simultaneously. And if there is a political will, pursuant to such advice of the pay commission, a bill can be introduced simultaneously in the parliament and the law can be made. Mm-hmm. Why there is a delay of 2 years?
Mm-hmm.
Can there be a justification? Is the government not accountable for not doing it simultaneously? These are the larger questions.
Is there a priority issue here? I mean, do you think the government already has a lot of work to do, and somewhere the priority in terms of salaries may not be among the top? Is that so?
I can't say that there is a question of priority, but as I said, this requires a complicated procedure to touch the constitution, only then a salary will be revised. You can make it simple, take out from the constitutional framework and make out a simple bill.
Right.
Then government can pass the executive order ordinance and can revise the salary.
And do you see any effort of that kind going into the bill?
Not yet.
And is there ever a consultation of this kind with the judiciary on such matters? Are you aware of any consultation that the government has held?
It was never thought.
Never thought of it.
And according to me, no constitutional amendment is required. It is only the seriousness which the executive should feel about it.
Sir, anything about the pension that you wanted to bring out?
What?
Pension, because there was a point made that the judges need to continue to draw salary even post retirement and not pension, so that their status can be maintained.
Rightly, there was some discussion that if the judge will draw the salary, continue to draw the salary throughout his life, then there is no need to give any work to him.
Mm-hmm.
And he should be debarred to take the arbitration, to take other works,
mm-hmm.
and help only the nation, that's all, in an honorary capacity.
Mm-hmm.
That is a good suggestion. Because now after retirement, people are looking for the jobs or looking for the arbitrations and earning more.
Mm-hmm.
They are not sitting idle.
Mm-hmm.
And so, if you will pay the salary, you will get a person who will do the honorary work if he is willing.
Right.
Give the honorarium, that's all.
Do you want to add to that, sir?
I want to add to this, that many legislations regarding tribunals, commissions, etc., that requires only the retired judges to be appointed to several posts. Now, therefore, you can take the salary, and if you take the services of these judges, you have to compensate them. Therefore, this will be highly controversial to say that the judges should be debarred from accepting any assignment after the retirement.
That is only if they are not on salary.
Not on salary.
Right, sir. Moving on, my colleague Nishtha Malhotra spoke to Mr. Justice R.S. Sodhi, retired judge of Delhi High Court, to get his point of view.
What does the bill seek to achieve?
The bill seeks to achieve a kind of a parity between the judicial services and the normal civil services, as also any other service. So it's a kind of a parity which has now been achieved, which was far due a long, long time ago.
Sir, why was there a need to increase the salary and other benefits of the judges?
So the need to increase the salary is a question which really defeats its own self. It was necessary because they were being paid far too little. Your bureaucrats, your military, your every other part of the service of the government was being paid far more. So it is also conceivable that the judiciary has the same requirements, and therefore the emoluments were increased accordingly. I think it's a good step, and we should welcome it. Why do you want to have a poverty judiciary?
Thank you, sir, for joining us on this discussion. It's time for us to end the show. You can email your suggestions and comments to law.rstv@gmail.com. You can also watch our shows on the RSTV page of YouTube. We'll be back with a new issue and a new episode. Keep watching Rajasabha TV.